Hey everyone, in this video we're going to be talking about the molecular weight of copolymers. We'll begin by doing a quick review of what a polymer's molecular weight means, what a copolymer is, and then go into a quick example of how we can calculate the molecular weight of a copolymer. So, if we remember back to some of our earliest chemistry classes, we are taught about the molecular weight of various atoms, which, if you remember, is typically given on the periodic table as grams per mole, which just means when you have an Avogadro's number of atoms, we have a certain weight of those atoms or compounds. So, we can write that the definition for the molecular weight of a given species is the sum of the atomic weights of all the atoms within the polymer per mole. Now, let's remember back to an earlier video where copolymers were introduced. A copolymer is a polymer that is constructed of more than one monomer, meaning that our polymer structure is made up of two or more different monomers. I will leave a link in the description below for a further clarification on what exactly a copolymer is and the different types of copolymers. So, now that we have reviewed what a polymer's molecular weight is and what a copolymer is, let's now go over how we find the molecular weight of a copolymer. Well, we can say that MC, the molecular weight of a copolymer's average repeating unit, is equal to the sum of each monomer's mole fraction, which we can call Fi, times the molecular weight of the monomer. As I just stated, this gives us the average molecular weight for a given subunit in this copolymer. Then, if we remember back to the degree of polymerization, we have the following formula. This states that the degree of polymerization is equal to the number average molecular weight divided by the molecular weight of the repeating monomer. When also applying this formula to copolymers, we replace M with MC, like so. So now that we have gone over the concepts and developed some relevant formulas, let's go through a quick example. Our problem states to calculate the number average molecular weight of ethylene polyvinyl acetate. Well, what is ethylene polyvinyl acetate? This copolymer is commonly used in spongy foam-like materials, such as flip-flops and the little foam blocks that kids play with, and things like that. In this example, we are told that the ethylene molar fraction in this copolymer is 0.65. Therefore, vinyl acetate, polyvinyl acetate that is, makes up 35% of this polymer's molecular composition. We are also told that the degree of polymerization for this copolymer is 2750. Firstly, we must find the molecular weights of both ethylene and polyvinyl acetate. You can find these simply by summing up the individual atomic weights of each of these monomers, or just entering the monomer name into a search engine. So, we find that ethylene has a molecular weight of 28.05 grams per mole, and polyvinyl acetate has a molecular weight of 86.09 grams per mole. We then apply these formulas for the copolymer's average repeating unit. In terms of moles, ethylene is 65% of our copolymer, and polyvinyl acetate is 35% of our copolymer. Therefore, the copolymer's average repeating unit's molecular weight is 48.37 grams per mole. Then, since we know that the degree of polymerization for this copolymer, we can now easily find the number average molecular weight. And we determine this to be 2,418.33 grams per mole. Thank you for checking out this video, and I hope it helped your understanding of what a copolymer's molecular weight is and how we go about calculating it. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our Patreon page to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.